humble before you, this presence of God, this morning. As we are going to hear your word, we want to pray for your intervention, want to pray, oh God, for your understanding, want to pray, oh God, for the Holy Spirit unto this place. Use me as your vessel, God, whatever you prepared for us today. Lord, may you use me so that we can deliver, oh God. It is because we pray and we are trusting in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us sit down. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God once again.
Amen.
Are you good?
Yes.
Are you good?
Yes.
Am I Korir? I'm saved. Christ is my personal Savior. It's been a blessing to my life since I was saved, and I've seen His hand. I want to thank God for this opportunity, and also thank Reverend for giving me this opportunity. I'm so humbled, and before your presence, it's not that I've done something good. It's not because of my position. It's not because there is something else that I have, but I know it's the grace of God. Praise God. And so this morning, I'm so grateful. I'm so blessed by the art and the songs and the way you people look. You know, when you are in front of here, and I tell you people, you are so blessed. You are so good. You are smiling. I think you need to clap God for that. And last week, we went with the men's of honor to Mount Kilimambogo. And when we went there, I was blessed to be part of them. And when I went there, before I left my house, I remember Reverend texted me and told me we'll go for prayer hike. So I received the message, but when I was left, there was something telling me that it is a prayer hike. It is a prayer hike. So I was confused. Is it prayer hike? Am I going? Can I take the sport clothes or teyata? Something tells me in my heart to go and actually play hata as a sports as in the combat. Before me talk to Kwanupa, something tells me no, it's a prayer. Really? So, nikakuwa napigana na hiyo, within some few seconds, nikakuwa napigana na hile mawazo, mimi binafsi. Nikasema, utarol, no problem. Nikatoa, nikarusha kwa kiti. Nikatoka, we went there. Tulipofika pale, ikawa sasa ni wakati wa kupanda ule mlima. Nikaona wenzangu, the men's, wanatoa sport shoes, wanavaa. Wanatoa zile ataya, wanavaa. And I was like, oh my God. Niliacha zangu. Na wajua nikuwa mevalia something like official. So I felt like, nipewe tu 2 seconds, and I'll be in my house, nipewe zile mbu, nifika hapa. Nikiangalia ile, I saw a body, and I was like, nipewe tu your flight. Nifika tu kwa nyumba, nitoe nirudi. Lakini it was not possible. What am I trying to say? Sometimes we have our convictions in our hearts. Sometimes tunakuwa na zile vita. But what I learned is, if you give a space, if you give your heart, the inner spirit is telling you which is the right thing, utakuwa in the right place. So usikuwe kama mimi ambao nili was like, sasa tunakimbia na sweat, nivaa shanti. Please, take heart, take time to listen to that voice, that inner spirit. That is the one that guides you. When you connect with that spirit, your inner spirit will connect with the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit knows what God is, what good is for you. And He will direct you and lead you to the right place. Praise God. So, you have a dream, you have something that you need to do, and you are confused, you are like, what shall I do in this place? What shall I do in this situation? Kneel down, pray God, and listen to the inner spirit of you, because that is the main thing. If you listen to what your inner spirit is telling you, you'll be on the right side. Many a times, especially human beings, we tend to want to do what our outer, ama tunataka kufanya ile ambayo una watamani au natafuta maneno mtatumia. We tend a lot to do what we want. We don't want to listen. We don't want to be patient enough to listen and say and pray God and tell God, God, what is your purpose for me? What is your purpose? What is your will upon this situation that I'm facing upon? But instead, we want to do. You say, no, I know this. Use your wisdom. The Bible says that. Do not lean upon your own understanding. Praise God. So let us not use that so that we divert in what we are a purpose for, but let's seek the Holy Spirit to guide us and lead us. I'm sure I know that you'll be a blessed person. Today's sermon, I call it Keep Going. Tell your friend, keep going.
Keep going.
Keep going.
Keep going.
We know each and every one of us is on earth. In this earth, you are not by mistake. Each and every one of us has a purpose. Kila mmoja wetu, no matter the way you see yourself, ukijiona hauna chochote sana, ukijiona you don't fit in that class, ukijiona you don't fit to that place. But remember this, that God has a purpose for each and every individual. In fact, kama haingekuwa majaliwa Mungu kama ukuje dunia hii, then you could not be existing. But now you are existing, shows that God has a purpose for you. In second reading, Christ himself underwent, it was the first reading from Isaiah 53, verse 6 to 12, it was a prophecy about the coming of Messiah, about the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, what he underwent. And when the time, when it was the time for Christ to suffer and to underwent all those, we see that he had the power. Despite he was being crucified, despite he was being mocked, despite that people rejected him, but he knew that he had a purpose to play. Even though akuwa anapitia yale akuwa anapitia yote, lakini alikuwa na purpose. And that's why atukupata kwamba Yesu Kristo alipokuwa akisulubiwa, kama ingekuwa mwanadamu, angefika mahali aseme kwamba I'm the Son of God and anapitia all this. No, God, just show them that I'm the Son of God. Angeurudisha. If you remember, ukiwa kama ni binadamu, mtu akikukosea, what do we do? We want to keep back. Sindio? Amejionesha sana yeye anaweza. So let me even show you. Kama wewe ni mbavu, kama uko na muscles, you want to show that person that you are able. Unataka kumuonesha kwamba hata wewe unajua, sindio? So, but what we learn from Christ that he knew the purpose. Despite all those alipitia, hakuwa anajua, at the end of it, there is a price to pay. Praise God. Each and every one of us, just as I started, you have your own dreams in life. You have that thing that you feel that I need to be in this position. As a student, as a businessman, I know we are businessmen here. As a Christian, you have that vision of your life. Because we are not just saved by salvation and that is the end. But we keep growing day by day. This one is new each and every day. And since now you have that dream of yours, you know that that is your purpose on this earth. And sometimes we tend to forget that. How do you know your dream? How do you know your purpose on earth? Can someone raised his hand and said, "How do you know the papa, your papa's on earth?" Can anyone know? And this is the time whereby you have that, as I started, you have that thing that pushes you in your heart. Unahisi sana kuimba, lakini ukifika hapa mbele, it ceases. Inapotea. You are frightened. You are like, ah, no, next time, I will do it. You have something that you need to do, it pushes you in your heart, lakini bado inasukuma. Ukifika ukitaka kuanza, inakusukuma. You have a lot of dreams. You have a future. So I want to tell you that each and every one of us in this place has a purpose to play. And unless you surrender yourself, unless you commit yourself unto Lord, you pray Him, you dedicate yourself unto Him, is when you know your purpose on earth. You're not just about having money. It's not just about having a good job. It's not just about enjoying life. Apana. There is something valuable. There is something big than that. Praise God. Praise God. And you are done as, not kama ni Peter sana, but I remember back, nikuwa na jiskuma sana. I want to be like someone. I want to be this and this. Until I realized I was stressing myself much. Nikuwa na jiskuma sana. Every day na jiskuma sana, nafikiria. I think 10 to 10, I want to be this. Nikijaribu kufanya hiyo, no. But what I realized when I pray God, is that each and every one of us has a purpose. I can't do what you do. You can't do what I do. Each and every one of us has his portion of life. Praise God. So just relax. Just pray God. And pray God so that you can deliver that what you have. It is a blessing. Kama ni sauti umepewa, mwimbie Mungu. Kama it's a gift of praising, worshiping, or serving God in many ways. When we say serving God, we tend to think that you go to church and serve God. It's not. You have many ways to serve God. Even in their house, you can encourage someone. You can mentor someone. Don't discriminate yourself. The book of Titus tells us, let no one discriminate your youthfulness. You have something. It's because God has a purpose for you. Second, surrender your life to God. Surrendering our lives to God. Have you surrendered your life unto God? Or you still in the world ambao unapigana na vitu za dunia? When I surrendered my life, I remember when I surrendered my life unto God, things started to flow. Things started to go until I was asking myself, like, mtu akiniambia something, I tend to push it on. And I was like, kama, nilikuwa namwachilia sana. A brother came to me and tell me to help him in one thing. It was, alikuwa na shida, akaniambia. But aliponiambia, I tend to kick it back, nikamwambia, "Hiyo tu peke yake ndio inakusumbua." So later on, I realized that I'm on another level. It's because I've surrendered my life to God. When you surrender, things just come. Unaanza kuangalia vitu vya dunia in a very, very different way. When you meet a challenge, it's not a challenge anymore. You see it like something that will come and pass. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God, church.
Amen.
Praise God, church.
Amen.
So I really encourage you, brethren. Let's surrender our lives to God. When you surrender and leave it to control your life, I tell you, it's just something else. It's just another realm. Just another realm. When things people see wakiona, ukisikia watu wana January wakisema, mchu imekuwa mumu. No. Where won't you? You just, things just come. You see the blessings of God. You see the favor of God. You see the grace of God. Ukienda hapa kama ni shida ya financial, I'm not saying that things will flow every, but this is how it is. When you surrender your life to God, you know that He will provide. I don't have today, but I know I have faith. Tomorrow will provide. God, will provide. Praise God. And you cannot just say that not surrendered your life to God. It's a high time. Don't wait until you get married. Don't wait until you have money. Don't wait until you have that dream, until you drive that big car. It's time for you to surrender your life today. It's time for you to surrender your life today. Praise God. Christ himself gave himself to God. When he was crucified on that cross, he said, God, if it is your will, let it be done. He surrendered his life, despite he was the Son of God. He surrendered his life unto God. Who are we as human beings not to surrender our lives to God? Praise God. So I encourage each and every one of us, please let's surrender our lives to God. That's where we'll encounter these blessings. We'll encounter, there are those dreams that you have. Back, I like to refer to myself. Mwanzo, I want to find sana about mambo na relationship. This is something that is ni kitu ambao, it's normal for each and every one of us. Know that we are so unique. Senyo, it's not a unique thing. It's each and every one of us fighting. So, unafika huu, unataka kufanya ile ambao unafikiria, you see this lady and you want to approach her, you want to use your own skills, you want to use your own vocabularies, you want to show other men that indeed at all pia unaweza. These are things that are normal. But let me tell you, until you surrender your life to God, utakuona sumbuka ni vitu. Utakuona sumbuka ni vitu. Mambo na pesa. You'll never, utakuona sumbuka na. When you surrender your life, you know that God has a purpose in your life. Utajua kwamba, I've surrendered my life and God will provide. When the time will come, things will just come. Praise God. So don't force things to happen when the time will not come. Don't force things to click if it is not your time. Every person, every human being has a season in his life. There are mountains, there are valleys. Praise God. And until we surrender our lives to God, when you are in the valley, you think you are in the mountain. When you are in the mountain, you think you are in the valley. Praise God. So I'm really encouraging you to just submit your lives, to just surrender your lives to God. As a youth, you have a lot to play. Kuna watu ambao, I really get encouraged when people come here and give testimonies. I'm so touched. And that is surrendering your life to God. We have many talents in the house. But until you surrender your life to God, is that when your talent will come and it will meet the right purpose. Rather than saying to us, "Go on a talent," but to use in the wrong way, in the wrong place. But when you surrender your life to God, things will be on the right place, on the right time. Praise God. When the time of marrying will come, it will be the perfect time. When the right time will come for you to have that job you are dreaming about, it will come on the right time and you will enjoy it. Praise God. So unless we surrender our lives to God, my brothers and sisters, unless we surrender our lives fully to God, not just by the words, not just by showing up, but unless we surrender our lives to God fully, when I do a bumper, it's me and my God, not even my parents, it's me and my God. You are giving the Holy Spirit, you are giving your God a space to control upon your life. Praise God. And thirdly, shape of the dust. Shape of the dust. How many of us hold many things in our lives? Be either your friend amekukosea, be either your mother amekukosea, be either your father, be either your sibling, be either any workmate, your friend, and your bossia, and still we have in our hearts. That means, unajua, kitu kimoja, wacha niwaambie, mimi ukinikosea sitaweza sahau. Sitaweza sahau. That's how we say. Mimi eti mimi nimsamehe. He has done for me this. I can't. I want to tell you, brother and sister, shake off that dust. Achilia. It's not because he's so special. It's not because he deserves to be forgiven. It's because he deserves peace. Praise God. It's because he deserves happiness. Don't live in this heart being stressed. You see what? I usually tell my aunt about and he was telling me, what shall I do? What shall I do? Tafanya nini na ulcer? And I have a testimony. I had a very chronic ulcer once time when I was still young at the age of 6. But as I grew up, when I knew God, and as I grew up, one time I read the book by this man of God, Mandro. And see, and when I read this book, it tells it, I get to encourage because it told me that if you are getting straight of these things of the world, then the world will not leave you, you leave the world. This life is so precious. Just leave once. Why are you so sticky? Why are you so worried? Why do you want to really, really get stressed about the things of that, about the things of tomorrow? And yet God is there for you. And then, and yet Christ died on the cross because of you and me. When he died, alikufa msalabani so that yale ambayo uko unasumbuka nayo, you can get a through pass. Be through him. Praise God. So I want to encourage you. I want to encourage you today. Just shake off all that is in your heart. If it is a worry, take it out. That you don't deserve about worry. If it is stress, take it out. You don't deserve that. If it is you have something that is obstacle in your life and you think that it is a burden to you, today I want to encourage you, my brother and sister, take it off. Take it off. You are so more valuable. If it is addiction, it's very easy to leave. If you surrender your life unto God, it's just a decision. It's just a decision. Someone told me that ukitaka kuacha pombe, si lazima mtu akuje akwambie uache. It's just you to make a decision once and say, from today, I think my life, my body is don't deserve these bad things. You might be thinking that alcohol is good for your life. As others say that ni chakula ya tumbo. Other youths are saying so. But when to come to your realization, it's not good. It's not good, brethren. I mean, you are so good when I see you like this. You don't deserve those bad things in your life. You don't deserve all those bad things. What is your difference between you who are being saved and them, those who are not being saved? And yet the other guy wants to involve you in what he does instead for you, kumshawishi, instead for you to comfort him and tell him, you know what? It's very hard for us to speak. But once we build the courage to say that word, I don't, that's good. Usikuwe mtu wa kuitikia tu vitu ambazo zinakuja. Ladies, usikuwe tu mtu wa kuitikia everything. Men, usikuwe tu mtu wa easy. You have to make decisions about your life. That you are living will not be that precious. You will not be that dream unless you make a decision to say yes to this and to say no to that. Look at Abraham in in the second reading from the book of Romans 4 says, Abraham, if we have faith in God, that he is in full control, that he is able to change, to turn what you see on your world realm, to turn so that you can see it the way God sees it. Only if we are faithful to him. Only if we are faithful fully to him. Where is your faith based on? Is it money? Is it the jackpot? Is it about peace? Is it about what you possess? Is it about your beauty? No. We need to take our faith based on the Christ, based on God. And that's where we'll encounter him and our lives will change. When God is being purified, when it underwent those stages and that process, purities has been taken off. Sasini inachoma. Inachoma, purities have been taken. Purities have been taken. Zinatolea. Until you see yourself in that goal. The same thing with our faith. As we go through salvation journey, we go remove impurities through this. We remove what is not good for us. We remove all those, the rebukes, the addictions, kusengenya, natoa. Praise God. Brethren, have faith on God. Let your faith be based on God. When you base your faith in God, your life will not remain the same. Your life turns. Your life changes. Until you meet someone and he tells you what is unique to deal with yourself. Ushai pata ama ushai kuwa na ile nafasi ambayo umeomba, ukafunga. Wakati umetoka, when you believe in God, normally, when you have faith, it's very, very funny. Sasa tunapitia mashida, it's when you have faith. It's when our faith is very strong with God. Sasa tunapitia these challenges, when you encounter this suffering, it's time when you kneel down and pray God and tell, oh God, please help me. Please help me, God. But when things are good, when things are well, I don't know what happens. We forget about God. I want to encourage you. No matter the situation, we've been told that when you pray when things are good, you are praying that you will win. You'll be a victor when the rough time will come in your life. Praise God. So it's not just about praying when things are good. It's not just praying when things are bad. It's being prayerful always, church. Praise God. And if you manifest yourself, if you manifest your life unto God, be a prayerful person. Be a faithful person. When you trust to God, when you trust fully to God, I don't have today, God will provide. That's being faithful. It's impossible when you sit on human realm. There is a certain company. Facebook. So you know it, but when I say my bomba and party pesa rana, you don't need to struggle too much. Come, we show you how you can have money. I was thinking like, I think God prepares each and every season in our lives, not in shortcuts, not to jump in another stage, leave another stage. Don't think God works in that way. God knows that from one stage to another, he prepares you for another. When you are in this place, he knows what you need. Not that God is so forgetful that he don't know you. Not that God don't know you, what you are undergoing today. No, God knows what you are going through. God knows our needs. God knows our inner spirit. Where we are weak, where we have the strength, God knows that. He only speaks to us that we need to